Hey everybody, welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This tutorial is part 2 in our 3-part series. In the previous tutorial, we created our name bar using expressions, text animators, set mat, and shape layers. If you haven't checked out that tutorial, I highly recommend that you do that before watching this tutorial, as we'll be building on what we learned last time. In this tutorial, we'll be creating our title bar. Make sure to come back tomorrow for the final installment of this series. Check out our new 7-Minute AE Tutorial store by following the link in the description below. Give me some help with that YouTube algorithm by giving this video a like. And share this video and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe to my channel and help us grow so that I can continue creating these tutorials for all of you. Click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video and leave me a message in the comments below. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the project file for this entire 3-part series, and the preset we created are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so we're going to pick right back up where we left off. In the last tutorial, we created our name bar, which animates out from this box. We added an expression, which we will be using again in this tutorial. I've included that expression in the description below, so you may want to have that ready. If you created the preset with me last time, you can pull it from your effects and presets panel, which is what I'll be doing when we get to that point. We also added a set mat to our text layer so that it only shows up within our name bar. We'll be using that same technique for our title bar. Now, if you haven't seen the previous episode, you may want to check that out before proceeding, but that summary pretty much gives you the gist of where we are at this point. Okay, so let's continue on with this lower third. Okay, so let's go to the end of our animation here, and then we can use some of what we've already created. Duplicate this name layer. I'm going to rename this title. Okay, now let's move that down, and I'm going to change the color of this to orange. Bring up P for position and bring this underneath. And for now, we have this set mat. The reason we can't see is because we have this set mat for this name bar. So let's just turn off our set mat. Don't delete it, but just turn it off so that way we can still see what we're doing. And then so if we double click on to our title here, I'm going to change this to my title, Motion Graphic Designer. But I want to do something a little bit different with this text. So I'm going to change, right now I'm at Gotham Narrow Ultra. I'm going to make this something like book, something that's like a lot thinner. I'm going to make the size a lot smaller. I'm going to spread out my tracking. And then just to see it better, let's open up our title layer. Remember, we have this text animator for text color. So I can open that up and make that white. So that way it just looks a little bit different, but it's still the same kind of font and it matches the family. Okay, and now see how it's animating from the bottom to the top. I want it to animate from the top to the bottom. So let's open up our animator here. And let's rename this to position. So that way we keep these text animators more organized. And see, our position is positive 100 pixels. And that's what's making it come from the bottom to the top. Well, if I change this value to say negative 100, now it'll come from the top to the bottom. So it'll fall in like that. And I actually want to place this on a bar like I did for my name. So let's create that. So let's right click, new shape layer. I'm just going to pull this underneath and I'm going to call this title bar and go ahead and make this orange. Okay, so within this title bar, we're going to add in a group called this title bar. And then within this title bar, we need to add in that secondary group for expression. Okay, so it's very important that you add in this secondary group for expression. Add in a rectangle and a fill. As you can see, it's hidden behind our name bar. If I turn that off, you can see it hiding right there. Okay, so I'm going to turn off our name bar. And actually, let's turn off our names so that way we only see title in our title bar. And let's just change this bar to dark blue. Remember again that our rectangle path defaults to a size of 100 pixels by 100 pixels. So we need to change our anchor point to negative 50 and our position to negative 50. And it has to be the value that's the transform properties of the expression group. Actually, for this to work the way we really want it to, we need to make some adjustments to our title bar as well. So as you can see, if you click on title bar, our anchor point is in the middle. Well, we're going to want this to animate from the left to the right. And we didn't have this issue necessarily with our name bar, but we're going to have that with our title bar. So let's open up our transform properties of our title bar, negative 50, negative 50. We didn't do this step on our name bar, and that's because it animated out of this box here. So we had a few other things kind of working. Well, with our title bar, since it's not animating out of anything, we want to make sure that this is going to animate from the left to the right. Okay, so let's go back over to where our animation on our text is. And again, make sure this text is left justified. So that way it animates from the left to the right. And within this expression group, click on scale here. And remember, we saved it as a preset. So let's go back to animation, presets, user presets, 7-minute AE, and double click on auto resize. If we open that up, notice that the preset saved it exactly as we saved it. It's referring to the layer name. Well, we want to refer to the layer title. So all I have to do is just highlight name and just change that to title. And now watch, our bar is going to auto adjust and it's about the same size. Now we can kind of move it around a little bit to get it where we want it to be. So click P on your title bar and let's just go ahead and move it at the layer level. We want to line it up. Something like that. So it's very important that you use the transform properties of the layer. If you open our contents, remember we have transform properties for the expression. We also have transform properties for the title bar. We want to make sure we're using the transform properties of the layer. Let's turn these other layers back on. Let's go back to our title here. Remember we have this set mat that we turned off. We can turn that back on, but now we need to change it so that it's going to refer to the proper layer, which is layer 6. So see now, as the text falls in, we can only see it on this layer. However, we do need to animate this scale. If we click on this layer and hit the left bracket to pull it over to where our title is, we're going to go into our transform properties of title bar. You want to click on the scale constraint settings, that way we can move these independently. Put a keyframe, and we'll make this 5, not 0, we'll make it 5. Put a keyframe and then shift page down 1, 2, then make this 100. And again, it's important that their final value here stays at 100. If you need to resize your bar, do that inside of the expression group. So we can uncheck that if you need to adjust this at all. Once again, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease in, keyframe assistant, easy ease out. Go to our graph editor and pull those handles over. Okay, and this is a little dark, so let me kind of lighten this up so we can see this a little bit better. I'm just going to make a temporary color for now. It won't stay this color, but just so we can kind of see what's going on better. I want this to actually to drop down, so I'm going to open up my transform properties, put a keyframe for position, and then go forward maybe 10 frames, so shift page down, put another keyframe there. And now let's move our scale keyframes over so it starts there. And then for this first keyframe, all I have to do is just simply pull this up. We're going to do the same kind of animation, easy in, easy out. Go to our graph editor and pull that handle over. So what we end up getting is something like that. Now, see, I don't want this box to be quite as tall. So again, we go into our expression group here, and this is where you're going to adjust that setting. So it's very important that you make these adjustments at the proper place. Command or Control A for all, and let's turn on our motion blur for all of these layers. And let's stop here with our title bar and our name bar now complete. Next time, I'll show you how to set up controls for this lower third using Essential Graphics. This will tremendously speed up your workflow and make changes so much easier. We'll also complete this lower third animation by animating it off. Basically, we'll be reversing everything we just created. But there are some things that you need to know, and it may not be as simple as you may think. Come back next time for the final installment of this lower third tutorial series. Hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Share this video and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you thought about this episode. Hopefully you learned something new and useful. And don't forget, check out our new 7-minute AE tutorials store. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the project file for this 3-part series, and the preset we created are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.